Hello, I'm Carly McAvoy. I just was talking about subtracting mixed numbers, and I looked at the first three examples that I looked at. Worked out nicely because we had a greater fraction on top and a lesser fraction on the bottom, so I was able to subtract those. What if I didn't have that? What if this smaller fraction was on top? Well, if I have an 8 in the front as my whole number and a 1 as my whole number, obviously I have a big enough number to subtract that smaller number, but it does require borrowing, and there's other methods to do this as well. In my opinion is, if you can do it with another method that you know and love, then that's fine. I prefer borrowing methods, so that's what I'm going to show you. So here's what we're going to do. First of all, we're going to look at one that doesn't need to be changed because it's already like fractions. We have 5 in the denominator in both of these. So I don't have to change anything, but I do have to borrow. What I'm thinking up here is I had 5 3/5. What I'm going to do is borrow 1 from the 5. I'm going to think about this as 5 + 1 3/5. I'm taking 1 away. Whoops, that should now be 4. I took 1 away from the 5, and now I have 4, and I'm adding the 1 3/5. Do you see how 4 and 1 would still be 5? Now I'm going to rewrite this as an improper fraction. 1 times 5 is 5, plus 3 is 8. So what I have up there, I just keep wanting to write 5, is 4 8/5. 1 times 5 plus 3. So I have 4 8/5 instead of, boy, I'm just having a hard time writing 4 today, instead of 5 3/5. Do you see how those are equal? 4 is 1 plus 5, and then I'm just going to make that into an improper fraction. And then I'm going to subtract 3 4/5. Now I have the greater fraction on top. 8 minus 4 is 4. Keep the denominator the same, and you have 4 minus 3, which is 1. So 1 4/5 is my answer to that one. What about the second one I have? Well, I don't have anything up here. Remember when I didn't have a fraction over here and I was saying, oh, just drop that down. That's because this is like having 0/6 or the smaller fraction on the bottom. But now this is like having 0/3 up here. And that's a problem. I can't take 2 away from 0 without using negative numbers, which we don't want to do. So I'm going to think about this as 6 + 1 0/3. What would that look like? 1 times 3 is 3 plus 0 is just 3, right? So what I have is 6 3/3. Do you agree that 6 3/3 is equal to 7? Well, 3/3 is 1, and 1 plus 6 would be 7, so that's why that works out. Now I'm ready to subtract that. I have 2/3 here. So I have 3/3 and I subtract 2/3. Remember, keep the denominator the same and subtract. So I have 1/3, and then 6 minus 1 is 5. Okay, so in that one, this one I didn't have to change anything. This one I didn't have a fraction. And now we have the third one, which is going to be our hardest one because we have everything to deal with there. What's the common denominator for not 12 and 9? Well, I can do that off to the side. You can use whatever method you want to use. The one that I've been using is the one where we do the upside down division. What number goes into both of these? It's 3. And then 9 divided by 3 is 3. 12 divided by 3 is 4. And you multiply everything inside here. So your LCD is 3 times 3 times 4, or 36. So I'm going to rewrite this way. I have 9 and 5/12, and I'm subtracting 6 7/9, but then I'm going to rewrite that with 9 and change that to 36, and 6 and change this to 36. Well, that would be 12 times 3 is 36, so 5 times 3 is 15, and 9 times 4 is 36, so 7 times 4 is 28. So I haven't done any subtraction. All I did was rewrite those to have a common denominator. And now I want to borrow. And what I had was 9, so I'm going to think of that as 8 + 1 15/36. And what would that look like then? Well, that looks like 8, 1 times 36 plus 15. Well, that's 36 plus 15 which is 51, right? So I have 51 over 36. And then I'm subtracting 6 and 28, 36 down here. So I definitely have enough to do that. And if you're not sure about your calculations, you can do those on a calculator as you go. 1 times 36, we definitely know is 36, plus 15 is 51. So great. And then I'm going to subtract 28, which is 23. So I have 2 and 23 over 36. Now I would say, can I reduce that? If you can see in already, you know 23 is a prime number, nothing's going to reduce. But you can also use your calculator to reduce. If you have this kind of a calculator, here's your fraction button. A lot of calculators have a button that's like A, B, or sometimes A, B, C, and those are the buttons you push to change that into a fraction. But for ours, I can do 23, this button, 36, and then just hit enter. And you see how that's still 23, 36? That means it couldn't be simplified. So that's my final answer right there. I'm going to do a few more word problems next that require some borrowing so you can see this process again. All right, have a fantastic day. We'll see you next time.